chapter 4, 2 Timothy chapter 4, will be in verses 1 through 4. On today, I'm here to tell you, if I step on your toes, then you shouldn't have had your feet in the way. Amen. If you got an open-toed sandals, you should have worn some clothes and shoes on today. I'm stepping on corns and everything on today. So if your feet ain't right, you got to get them right on today. I'm going to give you a spiritual pedicure on today. 2 Timothy chapter 4, verses 1 through 4. You sit still, and I will instill, and we will see what the Lord will reveal. The Word of God says, I solemnly urge you in the presence of God and Christ Jesus, who will someday judge the living and the dead when he comes to set up his kingdom. Preach the Word of God. Be prepared whether the time is favorable or not. Patiently correct, rebuke, and encourage the people with good teaching. Verse 3 goes on to say, for a time is coming when people will no longer listen to sound and wholesome teaching. They will follow their own desires and will look for teachers who will tell them whatever their itching ears want to hear. And verse 4 closes out, they will reject the truth and chase after myths. Word of the Lord is already blessed. If I was to derive a title for today's message for you to hang your thinking on, I would say it is this: the danger of a slow metabolism. The danger of a slow metabolism. Now stay with me on today, because I don't want to lose anybody. I want to teach you the word on today and put us in a position to receive everything that God has for us on today. But as I was studying and going through some different things, I realized when God gave me this message that I needed to give you a premise to bring my message to a logical conclusion. So I did some studies and I found out that doctors and weight loss experts' studies show that the older an individual gets, the slower their metabolism will become. Preaching right there, y'all don't even know it. Some of us been in church 10, 20, 30 years. Anyway, let's get back to what I'm talking about. In other words, our metabolism slows down. And it means the slower the ability to digest food and nutrients of any substance becomes stagnant and starts to slow down. That's why if you look at ourselves when we were younger, we could virtually eat anything and pick up no weight. We could eat all day long, and it seemed like no matter how much weight, we didn't gain any weight, because at a younger age, at a prime age, your metabolism is working properly because life hasn't hit you in any areas that would affect your physical. Stay with me on today. So let me teach you something today. Metabolism, what is metabolism? Metabolism is a term that is used to describe all the chemical reactions involved in maintaining the living state of the cells and of the organisms in our body. See, metabolism can be divided into two major categories. We have what's called catabolism, which is the breakdown of molecules, which is to obtain energy. And then you have the anabolism, which is the synthesis or the combination of all components needed in order for the cells to function properly. Now, catabolism allows the molecules to be broken down in order to have energy. You got to stay with me. Hear me out. Anabolism is the mixture of the components needed for the cells in our body to function properly. Look at your neighbor and say, properly. So this process, understand something, in the human anatomy, this process is so important that when either of these two categories are not working in conjunction with one another, or they break down, or they don't function properly, then our metabolism, in other words, our metabolism, the ability to break down substance, will be affected in a negative manner, and you will pick up weight. And what happens is you become fat. Now, I can look at we can look at each other's yearbook picture and tell that things have changed. For most of us, some of us still there. Some of us, life has come in different varieties, different ways that have affected our metabolism. metabolism to slow down. And so I understand that, you know, some folk may have a problem and don't like to be called fat. So I don't want to offend anybody on today. So let me use some different words that may sound better to you.
Be prepared. What is preparation? I need to know.
You should get mad at KJ when you was a teenager. A lot of your parents would know what I'm doing. 4 o'clock. Walking downstairs. Open up the refrigerator. Don't grab it.
He didn't stop playing and stop singing. And he didn't stop because what Elder
tell you that the Tony I see ain't the Tony God sees. Because God said that we're made in His image, we're made in His likeness. And Tony, I don't care how much you shave, keep yourself sharp, you don't look like God. No matter how great a suit, I don't look like God. Because God is a spirit, and you can't see the spirit. And we get so caught up in feeding His flesh, and we don't get caught up in nourishing our spirit, which is what's going to give us the power. There is power in the name of Jesus.
I don't know about it.
Because we done got holy and sanctified and saved, and we're not taking what God gives us today and using it up. We're trying to hold things over for tomorrow. But God said, don't you worry about tomorrow. I'm going to take care of tomorrow. And what's happening is we don't worry.
Burning gas ain't going nowhere.
God, then I won't recognize what's not flesh, and I won't recognize what's not tradition. So I have to run, I have to move forward in God. I have to, after I start running, I have to learn to eat correctly. To get in shape, you have to eat correctly. What are we eating? What are we feeding ourselves? You need to get you a big bowl of faith, and then get you a big meaty platter of hope. And then sip on the sincere milk of the word. See how full you'll get spiritually. And watch how healthy you will become. We spend all this money on a monthly basis, gym memberships. Oh, the end of the year coming. Oh, we're going to get in shape. We're going to join all this. Join Fitness 19. But have you ever tried Philippians 4:19? We get membership at Gold's Gym, but have we tried God's Gym? We keep trying to get memberships at LA, but have you tried El Shaddai? See, we need to change our membership and stop getting so caught up in the physical, but get caught up in the spiritual. Because if my spiritual is healthy, my physical is going to change. That's why you can't marry somebody based on looks, because trust me, give them 25 years, they're going to change. As much as y'all may not believe it, when I married my wife, it wasn't because of looks. Looks was a grave. That was a grave. I looked at her heart. I looked at her son. I need to know if she was spiritual. Is she submissive to a man? Is she going to be able to allow me to be the husband? Is she going to allow me to lead and be the man that God called me to lead? Because if she ain't right spiritually, I don't care how far she looks. In 40 years, I mean, she ain't aged since I met her. I mean, you look better today than you did the first day I met you, girl. But I'm just going to tell you this. But even if change came after 40 years, listen, as long as I know spiritually, she's there. See, we joining all this, but we need to get caught up in God. We need to understand who God is, what God has promised. You even know what God can do in your lives. You tried it your way. But have you tried Yahweh? Yahweh, Jehovah. Jehovah Jireh, the provider. Have you thought about him on today? Have you thought about Jehovah Rapha, the Lord who heals? Have you thought about Jehovah Nissi, which is the Lord of battle? Have you thought about Jehovah Mekadesh, which means the Lord who sanctifies and makes holy? Have you thought about Jehovah Shalom, the Lord of peace? I mean, you got all kind of crazy stuff going on at your house, and you feeding your situation with cussing folks out and giving people a piece of your mind. Let me tell you something, baby. You need every piece of your mind you can get. We already burnt about half of it in high school, so the other half you need to keep. You ain't got time to give anybody a piece of your mind. You need every bit of you got left. Stop feeding your flesh with all this other stuff. Have you tried Jehovah, Elohim, the Lord our God? You call it grandmama, mama, daddy, and they pray for you. When are you going to pray for yourself? When are you going to learn to feed yourself? Can I tell you? Let me tell you something. Here's where the situation happened. We're so done with that. If you're requiring your spiritual growth to be based on what I'm feeding, I can feel it. I'm capable of not fulfilling your need. I'm capable of messing up and preparing something wrong and putting the wrong spices in it. I'm capable of not cooking the stuff long enough or overcooking. But only God prepares it properly. When a baby is born, I got it. He said, put away childish things. The problem isn't putting away. mothers against daughters, daughters against mothers, fathers against sons, sons against fathers. The Bible said it's going to happen. But when is the church going to stand up and speed up our process of understanding the Word of God? And we learn